Other, no, you know what it's like. I mean, in commercial filmmaking, I mean, people tend to segregate, oh, this is a religious film.
Yeah,
but then
yeah.
you do have some movies that are religiously themed that really make it. I mean, The Passion of Christ, even Luther, the story of Martin Luther. Why is it time for the public to see his story?
Well, the context we're in right now, there's so much chaos, for example. It's like during the time of Ignatius, there was the Protestant Reformation headed by Luther. That was during
period,
that time.
Yeah.
So the whole world was collapsing at the time, as it were.
Yeah.
And
what,
so
what makes his story relevant today?
Because everybody is looking for what's the meaning of life now, you know? We're looking for handles, how to, you know, understand this life. And Ignatius, precisely his gift is, I'm sure you have read Rick Warren's The Purpose-Driven Life.
Of course.
Everyone is asking, what's the purpose of our life, especially in the midst of the chaos in this world? And Rick Warren tells us, and I think Ignatius was... he got the inspiration from Ignatius. Rick Warren's famous line, it's not about you, it's about God, of course. Mm. And Ignatius, of course, said that so many centuries ago. He was ahead. So that's his gift.
Yeah.
If we're looking for the meaning of our lives, the purpose of this, of our life in this world, in this chaotic world, you will not find it by being selfish. Maybe you can focus on God. So,
and what's
on
interesting
a greater meaning
about the film is you got a foreign cast, right?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
And the lead actor, Andreas, who is here right now, no, actually lives in London.
Yes.
He's Spanish, and it's your first time in the Philippines.
Yes.
Why did you take the role?
Well, I couldn't say no, to be honest, to this film. First of all, I received some sides. And there was a monologue about a soldier, and it was a dualism of characters on it. And after I seen that, I was like, wow, that has meat on it. And after they told me it was about Ignacio de Loyola, I was completely shocked about that, and I was really proud to take on board. And I couldn't say no, to be honest.
Yeah, but Ignacio de Loyola wasn't someone, I mean, even... You are Spanish, but
yeah.
He wasn't someone close to your heart then, growing up?
No, it wasn't. We knew about Ignacio, you know, of Loyola
exactly.
in Spain, but we didn't know a lot about him. That's why this film is good to have that kind of film.
And what part of the script or his life attracted you the most to do it?
The transformation.
Okay.
The transformation of Inigo de Loyola into Ignacio de Loyola.
Okay, and the film is in English.
Yes.
Did you have a hard time?
Yes.
I was going to ask you.
No. I trained as in Glasgow in Scotland, in the Royal Conservatory of Scotland. And at that time, while I was about to audition for Ignacio de Loyola, I was playing Hamlet in the UK.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah. So that was difficult,
so
to be honest.
So you can speak right now with, I mean, an English accent?
English accent, absolutely.
Can you do one now?
If you want, I can.
Really? No, I mean, you don't have a script, but...
No, well, with the script, I can practice
can,
American accent,
change?
British accent. Yes, of course. I've been training that.
Okay.
And even in Scottish as well, yeah. That's part of my training, yeah.
Okay, now, in the movie, I saw the clip. You had to look a little older.
Yes.
Did you have to behave and act older as well? And I would imagine, where would that be coming from, considering you're 26 years old?
Yeah, well, that was coming from the script, and then working on his life and his path. To be honest, I just follow his journey, because there's a leap of 10 years, 25 to 35, something like that.
Okay.
So that's what we were working on.
Yeah.
And it's been, a ride, you know, a really good ride to go through it.
Yeah. And the technical aspects of the film, I hope, Derek, we can show this.
Yeah.
You can explain this,
sure.
Paolo, no? This feature film uses state-of-the-art Arri Alexa XT. Okay, can we show that? Which is the latest, actually, in the digital line of cameras that has been used for many Hollywood films.
Right.
It's been used for Birdman, Life of Pi, Zero Dark Thirty. Why did you choose to go this route? I mean, that's what makes the film, actually, when you see the plug, look very Holly. I mean, I have no other way to say it, but global.
Yes.
International. Okay.
Right, right. Well, pretty much the technology is already available here.
Okay.
So we we wanted to take advantage of whatever was state of the art at the time.
Yeah.
And in fact, we used the Arri Alexa XTs. We used a really, really newly released set of lenses called the Cook Anamorphic 2Is.
Yes.
Which at the time we were shooting, there were 11 sets in the whole world and we had set number 3.
Really?
Yes.
Because it's the same lens and camera they used for the Avengers.
Yes,
imagine
pretty
that.
Much, yes.
So
we decided that, you know, there are several ways to attack a film, and given a budget that isn't in the millions and millions of dollars.
Yes, but
then
try
to invest in us.
Yeah. So even if the budget of the film wasn't big, you really invested in this kind of equipment.
Well, the philosophy was you try to get your whole, you try to maximize what you can do,
okay.
Right? So you can't really build massive sets or anything,
yeah.
But if your camera package is good, your lens package is good, and of course we had brilliant cinematographer, Lee Briones, who really pretty much blew all of us away.
Yeah, and where did you film? I mean, primarily.
This was filmed around.
It's a very Game of Thrones feel.
Yeah,
I told you, we were there.
We filmed in Navarra and Basque
Nevada,
country.
Really?
Navarra, north
of Spain. Yeah.
North of Spain.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's the same area. At the time we were shooting.
I was going to say, which is Circe? Is that where they filmed the Wolf of Shame?
When we were shooting around the area of Artajona, it's an old castle thing in the middle of Navarra. And we heard that the staff of Game of Thrones was casting
for it.
You know, because they were going to shoot like 2 months after we left, right? So
yeah.
it was like, hey, we got this location first. Why are we still here? That was fun.
All right, nice. We're showing you scenes right now. And so all of this was shot in Spain. Is it right to say you all used foreign actors?
Yes, our
okay.
cast was almost entirely from Spain and a couple from the UK, but you know. Pretty much all our performers were from there. But
because look at the landscape. I just don't think you can, you know what I mean? I don't think you can make it as real if you filmed it, let's say, in the Philippines or anywhere else.
Right.
So you really went for that authenticity. How many actors did you use, all in all?
Oh, it was a rather large cast, wasn't it? People would come in and out because we were tracking the journey of Ignatius from you know from where he started in Loyola and then to Manresa and so on and on to, but so there were people who would come in and out of his life.
Yeah.
So perhaps I guess around at least
56.
Now I'm seeing a Filipino crew.
Yes.
This is the production team.
Yes.
Okay.
All the key staff. We were all from the Philippines. And
it's amazing.
We had a support team from Spain. We had a Spanish production manager and lighting staff as well.
Is it easy to shoot in Spain? I mean, I'm curious.
In many ways.
Okay. You were there, Father Nono?
For 2 weeks, yes.
I'm impressed. Yes. Okay. Did you have some wine? No, I'm kidding. So, is it because I think it makes a difference in terms of film tourism.
Yes.
People will say it's so easy to shoot in New York. So easy to shoot in, you know, they really encourage it.
I will say that it's a bit of both because, yes, they do have really, really good structures over there. Like when we went to Navarra to try to find locations for the shoot.
They will help you.
The Navarra Film Council was very helpful.
Yes.
They had a catalog of places. What do you need? A castle, a waterfall, a river?
Yeah.
They had a catalog already.
And did you have a say, Andreas? I'm curious, in terms of your collaboration with the director, what's it like? Is it the kind of relationship he tells you, follow the script, do as I say, or you say, no, you know what, director, I think that this will work if I did this?
Yeah, no, it's been, he's quite flexible in a way that it was clearly well written. So I know that what he wanted. I know his instructions.
Yeah.
So I didn't have to ask a lot.
Yeah.
But my main question was about the journey of the character and the breakdowns of the character and what he wanted to show.
Is it a sexy movie?
Of course it's sexy.
You know what I mean? You know how it is that even if it has a religious theme, people want that sexiness in the character.
Yes, kind of between Game of Thrones, Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, okay, going on there. So what makes the movie sexy for commercial viewership?
Well, first of all, is as I said, it's a transformation.
Of course.
So he was a womanizer. He was a womanizer. Yeah. He was a sinner.
Yes.
He was a soldier.
So did you have sex scenes? I mean, funny. Really? Yeah.
Should I say that?
Yeah.
We're rated PG.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah,
yeah, but I mean,
you have to watch the film to find out.
You have to watch it.
He was.
You're gonna be impressed.
No. All right. Impressed. Okay. So he was a womanizer. Was he an alcoholic?
He liked to drink as well, and he liked to fight.
So it's this bad boy
character.
And the want for power.
Yes.
Okay, this Napoleonic complex.
Absolutely.
So to speak. And then, okay, go on. So he had love interests.
Yes, he was in love with, after being with different women, etc., he's been in love with Catalina de Aragon.
Yeah.
Who was the daughter of Juana la Loca.
Oh, who is the lead female character in the film.
Yes.
Who looks like Monica Bellucci, by the way.
Who looks like
a wonderful actor.
Go on. So it's sexy.
Yes, it's sexy.
Okay, all right. No, Paolo, was that important for you? I mean, I'm curious because you came from advertising.
Yes.
I mean, you lived with the pressure of, is this going to earn? Is this... I can imagine that even as a director, you would want a script that was gripping, a script that, you know, right. I mean... You get the point. That would like make you wow.
Right.
Okay.
Well, when Father Nona first approached us to put together the film, his main directive was, please speak to the youth. Please make it relatable, appealing to the modern audience.
Yes.
All right?
And Father wasn't being a party pooper, saying take that out of the script.
No, absolutely not.
No.
It's against my religious.
There were moments when Father was the one saying, "Let's have a battle scene."
So,
okay. It's wonderful. It was wonderful.
I found out something really interesting about the Jesuits that they are really open. They like to speak, and it's there. That material is there, so why are they not going to talk about that, you know?
Yes. That's what gets us in trouble.
Yeah.